Hey, what's up, Sparkers? Today's video, I'm going to show you volume, gain, master, output. We're going to talk about how you adjust and control, not only the overall loudness of the amp, but also, the effects chain, the volume and the gain. And we're going to talk a little bit about how you adjust and control, volume at every sort of stage of the signal. So there's the way volume, input, signal, gain, master, etc. works is it's kind of a, just like effects and the way this amplifier is structured, it works in a chain. And so, it's not necessarily super straightforward how this stuff works, unless you're familiar with it, unless you've played with it, and unless you, are... have really analyzed the way different gain stages and volume stages work. And so the way they did it with the Spark 40, the Positive Grid Spark 40, was pretty interesting, and it's very helpful and very useful, but it's also a little bit complicated, and sometimes, it's not necessarily super intuitive. So we're gonna talk about how each of those stages of volume, loudness, etc. works. And so we'll start off with the simplest aspect of controlling your volume, which is the output volume. So that's the knob all the way on the right. I'll show you that here. So all the way on the right of the amp is the output volume. And the way that works is it's essentially the overall loudness, right? It's controlling the overall loudness of your amplifier. So think of this as your volume control on your car stereo or your home stereo, right? This is, you're not changing the tonal quality of anything with that knob. You're just changing how loud it is. So, if you're in a house with a lot of people or a small apartment or whatever, you're going to want to maybe keep that a little bit lower so you're not waking up the neighbors or what have you. So you keep that low and you can just hear it yourself, or, no one's home, crank it, right? Go to town. Obviously as you get older, right, your ears change and maybe you got to keep that lower, but anyway, or you got to crank it so you can hear it. But anyway, that's how you control the overall loudness. So that works for both the speaker itself, or the speakers rather, as well as the headphone, right? So the output volume knob is going to control the overall loudness of the speaker. And that's the reason why that knob is not inside the app, because you don't have any digital control over the actual output volume. So hopefully that makes sense, right? That's just the loudness. And again, that's the simplest part of the equation here, because that's how you control the overall loudness of the amp. And then from there, it gets a little bit more complicated. So we're gonna start from the other side of the chain here. We're gonna start from the output of the guitar. So, every single electric guitar has a volume knob, and that's how you control the output volume from the guitar, right? That the amount of signal coming from the pickups and that knob is usually, close to the pickups, right? It's the closest one to the pickups typically, but not always. And so that's how you control the amount of signal coming out of the guitar. So that's very useful. If you want to get certain interesting sounds or dynamics, you can lower it. I personally almost always have it cranked all the way up to 10. That's just kind of the way I play, but to each their own. You can get more interesting sounds if you lower it a little bit, right? So that's the output volume from your guitar. And then the next stage in this process is actually the gain. So think of that as the amount of signal that you're going to be sending to the rest of the effects and to the digital amp model. And so the way gain works is, it's the amount of signal that you're pushing into from the preamp, it's the amount of signal you're pushing into the rest of the amp. So, if you have that low, you're not gonna push the amplifier too much. You're not gonna kind of hear any sort of, distortion or fuzz or drive, right? You're not gonna hear any overdrive. If you crank it, however, you may start to hear the sound, break up a little bit. That's where, kind of where distortion and fuzz and overdrive kind of started back in the day, was when the signal was pushed beyond what the tubes and the speakers were capable of handling. And so that's when you kind of start to hear that fuzziness. And so that's essentially how gain control works, is it's the amount of signal that you're pushing into the rest of the amp. And you know, if you push the gain pretty high, it kind of also acts like a sort of a compressor where it takes the signal and smashes it down just a little bit, because you know that's just the way the dynamic range works for gain control. If you set it high, you're essentially kind of squishing the sound a little bit. It does have an effect on kind of what feels like the loudness of the amp, but it's contained to just the signal. You know, a lot of what gain does, think of it kind of like a boost pedal, where you're increasing the amount of signal that you're pushing into the rest of the amp. So that's how gain works. You know, on some amps, you know, they have enough room inside the amp and you know, enough headroom where you can crank the gain all the way up and it'll still sound pretty clean. But in other amps, you know, that's a way that you achieve a certain level of overdrive or distortion sound is by cranking that gain up. And sometimes you'll have an amp that has two different, you know, amp models in it, right? So you'll have one that has a kind of a heavier drive to it and one that's more clean, maybe. And so that's how that works. That's how gain works. And then the next stage of volume control is actually called on the amplifier, it's called the master. And on the app, it's called the volume. So the way this works is think of this as the overall volume of the digital amplifier model, as well as the signal effects chain. So the master on the amp, I'll show you that here. It's kind of right in the middle of the amp. So you can see it says master right there. It's after the EQ, but before the signal, or sorry, before the effects. And inside the app, it's actually called, confusingly, it's called volume. And I'll kind of turn that knob here a little bit. So this is the master knob I'm turning on the amplifier, and you can see that it's adjusting the volume on the app, the amp model there. And they did that for a reason. It's a little bit confusing, like I said, because you would expect that to be the same nomenclature, but the reason it's called volume in the app is because, again, it's think of it as controlling the digital volume of the digital amplifier model. And it's called master on the amp because you're controlling the overall signal of that chain. So again, it's a little bit confusing, but the reason they did that is because you know, a lot of amps, whether they're solid state or tube amps, they sort of have a sweet spot of their volume, right? So, you know, they sound kind of ideal, or they give you the best sound at a certain volume. And, you know, that's not always convenient, right? If you have to crank the volume to, let's say, a six on a certain type of amplifier to get the right sound, you know, that may be too loud for everyday use. So they give you a way to digitally achieve that sort of sonic goodness, right? That sweet spot sound of these different amplifiers that they're modeling, you know, digitally, and not have to crank the volume, the output volume of your speaker that high. So it's a really, really helpful way to achieve those sounds. It's probably, you know, arguably it's the coolest part of how to use a digital amplifier model is because you can, you know, you can adjust the digital volume of the amp to get to that sweet spot, but not have to crank your actual loudness too high. So that's basically how, you know, the stages of the volume or the loudness works. So I'll give you a little bit of a sample of adjusting, you know, the different knobs at the different settings so we can kind of hear how that works. So we'll start off with the, you know, the guitar input volume, and we'll kind of go from there. I'm going to adjust the gain so it's right around the middle, and I'll put the volume, the master on the amp and the volume in the app right in the middle as well. And I, by the way, I have my output cranked pretty low. It's probably at around a two. And that's because if I keep it too high, it's going to overdrive my microphone here. So let's go ahead and get started with the volume control on the guitar. So that's my volume all the way up. I'm going to kind of take it down almost to one, but I'll have a little bit of it on. Now it's about halfway. This is about a seven. And again, all the way up. So now we'll adjust the gain a little bit, so you can hear how that affects the tone. Again, this is the gain generally affects the overall tone of your guitar, right? So you have it all the way down, not the tone, sorry, it has a more effect on the tone than a lot of these other adjustments. So I'm going to lower the gain down a little bit, to pretty close to, one or two. Crank it up to a four. There you hear, kind of that distortion sound coming through, right? And that's because we got the gain cranked all the way up. And so now I'm going to put that gain back down a little bit, and I'm going to go ahead and adjust that master. And what you'll hear is sort of the digital volume of the amp being adjusted. So I'm going to start with where it's at now, and I'll crank it down, and then I'll crank it up. So there you go. That's the effect of adjusting the master volume. So it's kind of a subtle difference. These different knobs, they all effectively have they do adjust kind of the volume or the loudness of the overall sound, but you can tell hopefully you can tell kind of the difference on how each of these operate, right? Just to summarize or recap here, the output control is the overall loudness of the speaker or the headphones. Again, think of that as the volume knob on your speaker, or your stereo or your car stereo or whatever. And then the volume knob on your guitar obviously affects the amount of signal that you're producing from your guitar, from the pickups. The gain is the preamp signal input, so you can increase that to push the overall sound to a higher place, or you can keep it low to not push or overdrive your sound too much. And then the master, which controls the digital volume of the amplifier and the effects. So play around with the different settings. Sometimes you're gonna like a sound with a lower gain and maybe a higher master. Other times you're gonna like it the other way around. And there's different reasons and different purposes for using them both of those ways, right? So play with it, have fun with it, experiment. That's always the best way to learn how this stuff works. But hopefully this helps you kind of learn a little bit about the different stages of volume or gain or master control. So thanks, and have a good one.